really got inspired. But the thing is, like, but what Ritu says is putting me off, that is going to even you out even after 20 years. What's the point?
Not even no. You off.
And, yeah, I just want to tell that, please. And not to put me off, like, even after 10 times, please, that it's not good.
No, I think what she meant is returns are more predictable, longer your time horizon. Yeah. So in the short term, 1 year could be 30% up, next year could be 10%
yeah,
up, then 50% up, then
50% up. You'll grow, but
in the long term,
in the long term it pays.
Yeah. It's like a GK1M block, how is ma'am? I mean, would it appreciate more in 1 year or 20 years? The answer is
I don't know about GK, but
see, no, I was just an example.
The thing is that you need not be scared of equities. You're all entrepreneurs. You are working at either your own companies or with some other companies. Now, supposing you were to be given shares of these your own companies, so would you feel confident in being a shareholder in your own company? I'm sure you would be, because you know the workings and you know this company is doing well, and you would like to participate in the growth of this company.
But tell me one thing, does a mutual fund only invest in shares?
No.
Or something else
also? No. That's bonds also. So there are two ways to look at it. So let's say you have a company and there are shares, ownership available for this company. So I could buy shares into it, and then I would participate in the growth of this company over the next 10 years, 15 years, whatever. The other way is that for you to grow, you want to take a loan. So I can also lend to you. That is called a bond, that I am giving you X amount of money, and you are going to, as a company, you are going to pay me an interest on it. So there are two ways to participate in the growth of a company. One is through the equity route, where you become a shareholder. Your risk also increases. There is no guaranteed return there. If tomorrow the company fails, I may lose my money. On the other hand, if I lend to you, then that loan could be backed by a security. One can always, you know, sell the office space and something, create some liquidity and pay off the loan.
But
that is a fixed return. So it does not give you an upside if your loan is at 9%, 8%. That is all you will make over the course of the investment.
Yeah, I think what she's trying to gauge is what all asset classes do a mutual fund expose.
Can I ask you one thing?
Sure.
Like, suppose if I'm investing through you, okay? But you take me the confidence where you're putting my money, or you do it on my behalf?
No, it's absolutely your money, so it remains with you and all operation of it remains with
okay.
You.
She's very advisable.
You have to be very actively involved in it.
No, there is no discretionary investment at our end. If we have to do it, we are licensed in a different way then. We just take it and invest wherever we like.
Thanks.
Very simple question. I just want to know the risk factor mutual funds, visible fixed deposits. To me, fixed deposit is English, I understand. Mutual funds is not English, I don't understand. How the things just go, even now, they're just going about. So I just want to know, very simply, fixed deposit versus mutual funds, is this the right comparison?
Well,
what
it's not. And
risk
I,
factor is something that I don't look at. And I want my investment to be very, very
Ritu, you know, all of us get intimidated with that ad. That man comes and speaks in 30 seconds. Mutual fund are subject to market risk. Please read your
quote. Somebody would speak English and be really happy.
Yeah,
as far as mutual funds are concerned.
In English, what does that mean?
Okay. Well, what do you think a bank does? When you give a bank a deposit, what do you think is the fourth work of a bank? Borrowing and lending, right? So the bank is borrowing from you in terms of the fixed deposit, and it's lending out to different corporates. That's what a bank is doing. It's loaning to different corporates. So what is a mutual? So within the mutual fund space also, like Raju just mentioned, when you want to be part of a company, you can either take part in the growth of the company by being a shareholder of the company or by lending to that company. The mutual fund is also, again, only a conduit. You know, it is not something... It's not a word which one needs to be scared of. It's just a conduit. It's really like a bank. You give money to the bank, and the money and the bank lends out to individuals, lends out to corporates. A mutual fund, in fact, will lend out to the lend out in government securities and to corporates, which will be rated, where you'll be it will be transparent. You will know where it has lent out, which companies it has lent out to. So mutual funds, there are a lot of mutual fund schemes which are available to you, which are actually an alternative to fixed deposits. It does exactly the same thing that a fixed deposit is doing. It's doing exactly the same thing in the sense that you're lending to the bank and the bank is lending further. You're giving money, investing into the units of mutual funds, and and those mutual funds are lending out or buying bonds of various companies. So, you know, so that really, so that's one type of mutual fund. But typically when you understand mutual funds, you think about it as equity market investment, because you look at, so that's, so mutual fund is really a vehicle which invests in gold, it invests in short-term bonds, long-term bonds, and equity funds. So equity is just one kind of mutual fund. There is, so fixed deposit cannot be compared to the equity mutual fund, if that's what you, you know, always thought of mutual funds.
Security-wise.
Yes. So, but the fixed, but the fixed deposits is very comparable to bond funds, which give you a certain, because the way the return, the bank gives you, makes money and therefore gives you money, is essentially the interest that it's earning on its investments, which is the bonds that it has lent out to. Similarly, the mutual fund also, debt-based mutual funds, these are debt-based mutual funds, which are very similar to fixed deposit. In fact, better than fixed deposits because of the tax efficiency that they have. That's built into the product.
I would like to add something here. Someone does not want any risk at all, and you say, oh, I'll just remain in fixed deposits. So what is the risk by remaining only in fixed deposits? That is the risk I'm talking about. The risk is that you stop working at 60. Now the lifespans have gone up. You have to provide yourself at least till age 90, 95. So there's another 30 years beyond your retirement you have to provide for today. And look at the medical expenses. I mean, one knee transplant, one, you know, some operation, one angioplasty, how much that costs? Have you factored into that? And would your investments, because you're averse to risk in fixed deposits, be able to meet those requirements? And if not, then I would say that gradually, slowly sit with an experienced person. You have to walk out of your comfort zone and dip your feet a little bit into different asset classes. Yes, they are more risky. What is risk in an equity product? It is mainly volatility. So if your time horizon is long enough that you're willing to stay put for the next 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, then like Ritu mentioned earlier, it evens out. The volatility will even out. Ultimately, an equity product will give you a return of the underlying securities it holds, which are the shares in these companies, which are growing. And India has a great future. I think all of us sitting here agree to that. That this is where the growth is going to be in the world in the next decade, two decades, given our demographic profile. So why not participate in this growth? But if you've never done it before, take a step at a time. The risk is that you invest in equity, and the moment it falls, you want to take it out. You get nervous, you get panicked. That is the fear. And you don't have to start with, you know, 50 lakhs or 1 crore.
Yeah, start with
you can start with 500 rupees per month.
So this question stemmed out from an experience. UPI.
Sure.
Government backing, right? Fixed deposit or fixed deposits. When the market was down, I didn't hear from UTI for 4 or 5 years. I just started hearing from them. And my fixed deposit, which said 10% or 9%, it gave it to me, right? So my concern is arising out of there. So therefore, what I understand, mutual fund is good, excellent for long term, risk factor is there.
I come back
to the point that I was making. There are mutual funds of all kinds. So when you cannot compare a mutual fund which had invested in equity, I don't know the scheme that you had invested in, with your fixed deposit 10% return. You can compare a fixed deposit return with a debt-based mutual fund, and that would have given you equivalent return as fixed deposits, in fact, better on a post-tax return.
Understand the English.
we will speak on that in Hindi.
What's your native language? Yes. Let's take
English that I can understand, which is not so jargon.
I would just like to add here, there are few schemes of the mutual fund which just invest in, let's say, Bank of India, certificate of deposits. So, you know, we as a corporate, we are also very, same question, we are also asked, why should you invest in a mutual fund versus a bank deposit? So there are, the one is mutual fund offers you the tax advantage. And second thing is, if you are so much, if we don't want our money to fall at all, then there are a lot of schemes available which just invest in bank certificate of deposits. So, banking and PSU fund, and PSUs are typically AAAs, and bank could do all certificate of deposits for 1 year. So you know that will also, there are many schemes which are available, and we are frequent investors into that. Just comparing that to a bank deposit, but from a tax perspective, you get a better return.
And that's where a financial planner comes in. You don't have to worry about anything. We have four intelligent ladies here.
Mutual funds. They manage themselves.
Is there like some instrument within the mutual fund